What's going on, you guys? Ladies and gentlemen, thank you for watching this video. I'm gonna take my actually and two cents and depth position in this video about the Orlando shooting that just took place a few days ago. Very disturbing news, man. I just wanna say rest in heaven to the people that perished during that massacre, man. They said that it was actually one of the worst shootings in history, man, as far as U.S. history. Now, it's very debatable. Like I said, if you want to compare that, you can compare it to maybe to the Sandy Hook. As I said, that maybe was a hoax, aka Adam Lanza, who really wasn't a real person. He was really mind controlled from the MK Ultra, which is a secret government agency. So I can probably really go into detail for another video for the sake of time. But you know, as I continue to research about this news. Actually, I did a little bit of research, but I didn't really put too much in depth into it because there was so much going on, and I just don't really like having my energy transferred to negativity. But I mean, this has to be said, and we got some Christians out here. You got some people, believers, that believe that it was God's will. I won't say God's will, but God cannot be mocked, and you're not supposed to put yourself in a position really to be homosexual. When you become homosexual, you open yourself to a lot of demonic portals and demonic spells and a lot of entities that can come in and take over your spirit. You know what I'm saying? And just exercise you from the Holy Spirit, which is very true. But at the same time, I always look at it like this. We're straight. Even if you're straight, you still have sins. No sin is greater than the other. Okay? And, a lot of people compare it to Sodom and Gomorrah when he destroyed it. But at the end of the day, a life is a life, And I look at it like this. Everybody has gifts. Everybody has talents. Everybody has abilities to share in this world. And when you kill someone, you kill multiple generations. You never know when that person might have a divine revelation with God, to the point he can change from his ways. Now, this is not disrespect to the homosexuals. They may come to their senses like, it's really not right to become homosexual. I'm going to change my ways. I'm going to read the Bible. I'm going to continue to find my life purpose and fulfill my testimony. But when you kill an individual, any type of individual, okay, if he's a thug or anything, you it's like you put a mark in the universe. And that's what really hurt me. That's what really got me pissed off. A lot of people, we love to justify in our own sense. We love to throw the complaining things around and like to point fingers and judge people for what they deserve to get. And at the end of the day, man, we got to clean our front porch. Shout out to my mentor, Ty Lopez. He was saying, if everybody took the time, the mentality to focus on their business instead of everybody else's business, this world would be a better place. And also to continue to have that mindset to encourage one another to continue to lift up in this universe. But at the end of the day, man, the guy just came in here with an A4. In Orlando Club. Now, that's the M4, man. Now, I used to play a lot of Call of Duty. That's a military assault rifle, man. Now, approximately have about what? I think I have about 30 mags. So, 30 bullets or whatever. And he shot over 100 people. Killed like 55. Injured like 53. Something like that. 103 people. And I'm looking like this, man. Okay, so, you know, 30 mags and, it was like a trigger finger. So, he had to at least reload at least about 3 times. You know what I'm saying? To actually to be that accurate. So to kill over, to shoot over 100 people. Now, at the end of the day, like I said, I remember EDP445 was making a video when he said that it was no cameras. It was no type of footage. But at the end of the day, it maybe was, but they probably were killed. You know what I'm saying? I mean, somebody coming in with a military assault rifle. At the end of the day, you're trying to survive. You're trying to hide, run. You don't know what to do, how to defend yourself if you don't have no type of weapon. Now, It's sad, because I used to live in Orlando for like 6 months back in 2013. No, I never went to a gay club, but I know where it was at. I used to go to this club called Vane, which was a very, very popular club. A lot of celebrities used to go there. I met Justin Bieber there. Romeo used to go there. A lot of people used to perform and promote their music and their business there. And it was a really cool club. Thank God, and I thank God from the heavens, man, above that. It was no shootings. It was a fight there, but it was no shootings, man. And I know typically 90% of clubs, they always check you and pat you down. I guess the guy, this had to be planned. I don't know if this guy was some type of government agent. He was operating off the reptilian agenda. You feel me? You gotta understand that. At least reptilians, they here to, I was just talking to speak about that. They here to, fulfill the New World Order as to control our gun laws. Same thing that happened, I think, a few years ago with Sandy Hook. And when Lil Wayne had that movie, not that movie, but that music video, My Homie Steel, and he foreshadowed what was going to happen with the skeletons in the background of the movie theater, saying people was going to get shot in the Colorado shooting. It's a lot of stuff going on, man. Sandy Hook, like I said, even though that was a hoax, when Sandy Hook happened, Batman, it was that Batman movie. And then I actually had an elementary school there where it was dead and vacant. So, I mean, all of this stuff adds on, it leads our movies are foreshadowing what's to come. You have to understand, too, that these movie theaters, everything, these people who make these movies are master occultists, man. Hollywood is the master occultist. Now, I don't know if this is a hoax or anything, but this is kind of crazy, man. They want to blame it on ISIS, even though this is domestic terrorists. And all Muslims are not bad, man. I mean, I went to school with Muslims. I work with Muslims. You know, we have a city in Dearborn. That's about maybe 75 to 80% Muslims. And we don't hear too many domestic terrorists like that. You know what I'm saying? And I think this is really the brink into fulfill. If Donald Trump becomes president, he wants to build a wall of immigrants. This is probably an excuse for him to ban all Muslims from the country, and that's going to create a World War III, man. That's going to create so much strife and tensions, man. You can't just blame for a simple act of blame the whole race or whole type of group or, you know what I'm saying, or religion. This doesn't make any sense to me. And I feel like this is what this world is coming into. You know, we love to complain and point the fingers instead of helping us or really helping ourselves and mastering ourselves. And it all comes from too when I'm studying astrology since I was 19 years old. You have to master yourself. You know, stop pointing the fingers. You know, and this is what I hate. You know, this is why we can't go anywhere, and this is why the Starseed Children that's here to change this economic power in this world. It keep going down. They want to lower our vibrations to things like this, man. To things to instill fear in our hearts. You know, to turn our way from God's word. To turn our ways from righteousness. You know, to get us off track with this story. You know, it's real sad, you know. And I feel like it's going to get, like I said, it's going to get even worse, man. It's going to be a point in time we're not going to be able to live in our homes. We're going to have to maneuver outside, you know, these FEMA camps. As President Obama signed the executive order, okay, you can look that up. It happened in 2015, June 2015 last year, when he signed, basically, he gave us, he okayed for slavery. Basically, not capitalist slavery, because we already in that, but physical labor and slavery and under FEMA camps and concentration camps. So if you refuse, like I said, the RFID chip, which is the 666 chip that helps you to get buy and sell things, you can read the book of Revelation, you will be perished or you will have no rights in this country. So they really, everything is coming to a close, man. It's the secret societies are really pushing forward that agenda. And that's why I feel like this is going on. It's a hoax, man. MK Ultra, you guys gotta watch that. Google this stuff. Put it on YouTube, man. We live in the information age. It should be no reason that you guys should not know this type of information, or just a little bit. You know, so don't take this for the minimum grain, man. Grain of salt, but you gotta do your research, man. This is fishy, man. Like I said, like to the homosexuals, man, gay people. I mean, like, this part might be a national holiday. I was talking to my friend. This might be a national holiday for the LGBT community, to be honest with you. You know what I'm saying? But it's really disturbing, man. I mean, these people didn't deserve that, and like I said, they killed my man, but at the same time, usually police officers usually be around the area. So when he was shooting all them shots, I'm pretty sure police should be on deck. It's downtown. It's a lot of tourist attractions. A lot of people want to go there. And now I don't know if they're still in fear to the point that, oh, man, you know, people don't want to go downtown because that's where all the money is at. You know, but at the end of the day, man, you know, stuff like this happen, man. You just gotta, we're not gonna put too much of our emotions into it, but we gotta really think outside the box. It's like, what's really going on? You know, are they really performing rituals? Like they assassinated most of our legends. That's how I think about it. It's real sad, but that's my two cents into this. Man, you know, we just gotta defend ourselves. We gotta arm ourselves. We gotta store water. We gotta have our own type of weaponry, man, to defend ourselves. It's gonna be real. I don't know. I just have a feeling maybe our government is gonna go against us because we're in the age of Capricorn, which is the destruction of our foundation, destruction of our government, which is from 2008 to 2021. So whoever becomes presidency, man, they're really gonna reform these gun laws. And like I said before I close, before Hillary Clinton becomes the president, when she was chosen by Bilderberg, her whole purpose, right, is to get rid of our guns. This is going to be a great excuse. She's going to have a powerful voice and speech, and she's going to use this for her defense. And I believe we should not take away our gun laws, you know, because when you take away our guns, the government has complete control of us and we won't be able to defend ourselves when shit really hits the fans. That's what they want. They want us to really depend on them and depend on the system. If you want to unplug from the matrix, you have to be self-reliant. You have to be independent. You know, you can't really put all your trust into corporations and into your own government. You maybe can use them as assistants, but you got to do things for your own. Like, you got to be a builder. You got to learn how to store your own food, grow your own food. You don't have to rely on the gas. It's deep, man. But it's your boy Young Lincoln here, man. That's all I got to say about this story. Rest in heaven to all the people that perished, you know, and all the families, and my condolences goes out to them. All right, I'm out. Deuces.